starch is react with iodine. It produce blue color. Because starch having that helical structure, so these helicals holds that iodine, holds that iodine to produce blue color. To produce blue color. Starch is react with iodine. Starch is react with iodine, it produce blue color. Because starch having that helical structure, this helicals holds that iodine to produce the blue color. Okay? So just like that. Just like that. So these are that helicals. Okay? And when that cellulose react with, when cellulose react with iodine, it does not produce blue color, because cellulose is that linear structure. Cellulose is linear, straight or straight. That's why, so that it does not hold that, it does not hold iodine. Okay, so because helicals are absent, helicals are absent. It is an important point about that. So starch is react with iodine, it produce blue color. Starch helical structure, so these helicals holds that iodine to produce blue color. These are the helicals. Cellulose react with iodine, it does not produce blue color, because cellulose is a linear structure. Cellulose is linear or straight, so that it does not hold iodine. Okay, it does not producing blue color because helicals are absent. Okay, so that is known as about that starch and cellulose. After that, the cellulose example, for example, cotton threads are cellulose. Paper, cellulose. It is made from pulp of tree. Pulp of tree. Okay? So next, generally, this all are that, generally the homopolysaccharides. Okay, some polysaccharides are complex. Some polysaccharides are amino sugars. They are chemically modified sugars, they act as the building blocks. Okay, so for example, glucosamine, N-acetyl, galactosamine, next, exoskeleton of cockroach, and cell wall of fungi, made up of chitin. These are complex heteropolysaccharides. These are complex heteropolysaccharides. Okay. Cotton threads are cellulose. Paper is also cellulose. It made up of pulp of tree. Some polysaccharides are amino sugars. They are chemically modified sugars. For example, glucosamine, N-acetyl galactosamine, exoskeleton of cockroach, and cell wall of fungi made up of chitin. So these are complex heteropolysaccharides. Okay. After that, nucleic acids, so generally it means along with polysaccharides, and polypeptides, protein, and fatty acids, another, okay, acid insoluble molecule is present. Along with polysaccharides, polypeptides, and fatty acids, another acid insoluble molecule is present. It is known as nucleic acid. So this nucleic acids are also, okay, biomacromolecule or acid insoluble molecule. They are considered as biomacromolecule. Okay. So this, in that biomacromolecule, okay, so for example, in the nucleic acid, generally nucleic acids are polynucleotide chains. polynucleotide chains. There, okay, the basic unit of nucleic acid is known as basic unit of nucleic acid is nucleotide. So that is the basic unit of nucleic acid. That is, so many nucleotides, okay, combined to form a chain. So that is known as a polynucleotide chain. So these polynucleotide chains are okay known as that nucleic acids. In each nucleotide, nucleotide having three basic components, so first one is that nitrogen base. So this nitrogen base is, these nitrogen base are heterocyclic compounds. The nitrogen base are heterocyclic compounds. Okay, so these heterocyclic compounds are the nitrogen bases. For example, adenine, A, guanine, G, cytosine, C, thiamine, T, and fifth one is that uracil. It is indicated that U. Okay, they are the heterocyclic compounds. For example, adenine, guanine are considered as purines. They are the purines. Okay, so they are the dicyclic compounds. So they having that two carbon nitrogen rings. It is important point about that. Two carbon nitrogen rings are present. They are the dicyclic compounds. What are that? Adenine and guanine. So this adenine and guanine are known as that purines. Remaining that thiamine, cytosine and uracil. So these are that pyrimidines. They are that monocyclic compounds. So generally in this carbon nitrogen rings are one carbon nitrogen ring. Only one carbon nitrogen ring is present. So that is known as that, okay, purine. It means pyrimidines. Generally, adenine, guanine, purines are present in that DNA or RNA. For example, and thymine, cytosine are present in that. They are known as the pyrimidines. So thymine, cytosine are present in DNA. In RNA, okay, instead of thymine, uracil is present. In that RNA. So these are that, okay, nitrogen bases. Okay.